All right, hello and welcome everyone to this special webinar where we'll be discussing ads.txt. And with me today I have Ohad Tzur, who's our Vice President of Business Organization and also a former Googler. So welcome, Ohad.
Thank you, Tyler. Happy to be here.
So we're going to talk a little bit about ads.txt today because there seems to be some confusion in the marketplace and then also just a lot of unknowns. And so what I thought we could do is just start off on what is ads.txt.
Yeah, so Tyler, ads.txt is a hot topic in the market today. To explain the mission, ads.txt is coming to increase the transparency in the programmatic ecosystem. The concept of domain spoofing is pretty much familiar to all. That means that bad actors can actually represent traffic that they don't have. For instance, someone represents the New York Times and then sells that to the branded buyers without having any inventory. So how can the programmatic ecosystem prevent that? Here comes ads.txt. What is it? So it's a methodology. It's a publicly accessible file that basically allows publishers to identify who can represent their inventory and who can sell that. So this would be recognized by the buyers.
Okay, that makes sense. So who is it really for? So there's a lot of different players involved in this. So is ads.txt really for the publishers? Is a means of protection for them?
So actually, it's a connection to basically secure the programmatic ecosystem for both sides. It is for publishers. Publishers would be updating that by themselves. It's only their webmaster that can do that activity. But it's actually for the ecosystem to signal to buyers, this is authentic traffic, or this is a authorized reseller for this inventory.
So where does this come into play then for parties like Google, for example?
Right. So if Google is trying to enhance the quality of the ecosystem and definitely satisfy their advertisers, they would encourage publishers to use the ad.txt to prevent those bad actors from taking action in the ecosystem. So it's their interest basically to roll this out to the entire industry. Now, the question that everyone wants to ask is, well, we understand who wants to do domain spoofing for New York Times. Is that true for a mid-sized blogger? Maybe it's actually not relevant for them. We just attended the Google Think Publishing event a couple of weeks ago and heard multiple perspectives. One is that domain spoofing would always trickle down to the next layers of publishers. So maybe it is something that would be more common in the ecosystem. Another one, that this is really a play for the big and branded players. So if you know that you have issues with domain spoofing by other actors, namely your brand, you should use it. Otherwise, there's no need and no point for that.
So as a smaller publisher, do I really need to be doing anything in light of ads.txt right now?
So that's a good question. Currently, actually, no. So if you're not participating in the ad.txt campaign or project, you can still monetize via Google. The downside is that Google cannot protect you in case there is a case of domain spoofing or counterfeit activity. If you are participating in ads.txt, you just want to make sure that it's up to date with all your resellers, because Google will not monetize unauthorized resellers that are not mentioned in your ads.txt file.
So that makes sense. So I guess what are the risks of doing it now versus what are the benefits of adding an ads.txt file to my site?
Right. So I mean, the risk is that this is a fairly new project. If you're not sure about who are the networks that are bidding or are representing your inventory, then you may be in a situation where if you forget a network and they're representing your inventory, Google demand sources like AdExchange cannot buy those sources. So if you do have that ad.txt file, you need to make sure that all your authorized resellers are mentioned in that ads.txt file. It's still new. There's probably still going to be some changes in the ecosystem, and some people are just waiting to see where that's going. The benefit, once again, I mean, if you are facing issues with domain spoofing, this would basically help you solve them because you're entering a much more higher quality secured ecosystem of programmatic buying.
So basically from this point now, and then looking back in the past, there's really, if you're not to implement ads.txt, you're really not going to see any difference, right, in the way that your site is monetized or who's able to monetize or what advertisers are able to buy inventory on your website.
Correct. And there's confusion in the market on this because I've seen multiple emails from vendors that I think may be confused as well. So just to clarify, if you do have that ads.txt file on your site, you need it to be updated in order for Google to make those bids via DFP, via AdExchange. If you don't want to participate and you do not have the file, Google can still bid on this. So there's no penalty for not having the ads.txt file. The worst case for publishers is having a file that is not up to date, because that basically means that some of your inventory that is represented by a unauthorized reseller is not going to be sold to buyers.
So if you choose not to participate, really nothing is going to change. Your website isn't necessarily going to be affected. If you would like to participate and try to take advantage of a more protected ecosystem, the most important thing would then be to make sure that your file is up to date and implemented correctly. Otherwise, you could see a drop in your ability to monetize your website.
That's absolutely correct.
Are there any other status updates or upcoming deadlines that publishers need to be aware of as it relates to the project?
The only one is by the end of October, if you are participating, make sure that your file is up to date with all the networks that represent your inventory. That's the only one. Nothing else at this point.
And so for Ezoic publishers, is there anything specific to Ezoic that they should be aware of about this project?
Yeah, so that's a really good question. Luckily, we have the chance to do a lot of the updates for you. So if you do have the ads.txt file, Ezoic will already go and add itself and the networks associated into your ads.txt file. If you are an Ezoic publisher and would like to add the ad.txt file, look for an app that is supposed to be launching next week on our platform that would allow you to put all the networks that you want to be authorized into that file. It's just going to be a simple app in our app store.
Excellent. Well, thank you, Ohad. Is there anything else that you think that publishers should be aware of as it relates to this project, ads.txt, or anything else related to domain spoofing or the ecosystem?
Yeah, so you know, one thing that it's important to note, when these launches occur, a lot of times there are a lot of chatter in the industry and there is misinformation by different types of companies. I recommend that you either stay in touch with the actual site project for ads.txt that is usually updated once every few weeks, or reach out to your account manager at Ezoic or us to get some updates directly from Google.
Excellent. Well, thank you very much, Ohad. We look forward to hearing more about this project as it continues forward, and we'll keep our eyes on the App Store for that application that you mentioned that will be available here soon.
Great.